We'd like to welcome Dr. Davi Gomes, who is going to come up and bring greetings from our sister church, the Presbyterian Church of Brazil. Would you please give him welcome?
Thank you. What a privilege. Mr. Moderator, sisters, brothers, it is indeed a joy for me to bring you greetings, to look at such a beautiful young mature lady as the EPC celebrating her 43rd General Assembly, to bring you the greetings from your older sister in the real deep south of America, which is the 160 years old Presbyterian Church of Brazil. I'm not sure that all of you know how important a role you've had by God's grace in making sure that the Presbyterian Church of Brazil has remained faithful in her witness to the gospel in the last few decades. But an investment that was made through a partnership between the old moderator or president, as we call them in Brazil, back in the 90s, and Andrew Jumper, your Andy Jumper, they created a school of theology, which now has around 2,200 graduate students. I don't mean graduated students, I mean actual graduate students in course now. So it has influenced the denomination. And the IPB, like the EPC, is a church that is in love with evangelism, with seeking to foster the vitality of the church, and working to see the glory of the Lord cover the earth as the waters cover the sea. So I'm privileged to bring you those greetings. I also have the honor of greeting you on behalf of the World Reformed Fellowship, which is an institution that has a significant contribution on your part. I'm not sure all of you know about that, but currently, our chairman of the board is Rob Norris, one of your own. We also have on our board Reverend Todd Smedley, Reverend Cameron Schaefer, and your own, my dear friend, your stated clerk, Dean Weaver. They're all board members. We also have the privilege of counting with the important work which is done on our Commission on Evangelism and Missions by your own, Case Thorpe, and by Steve Curtis, who is here, I believe. So obviously, in terms of being represented, the EPC has been an important partner. Now, I want to close the greetings on a very personal level. See, my heart is warmed by seeing the passion that you have for the one thing that moves me in this latter part of my ministry as a pastor, which is this passion and this deep desire to see the global visible Church of Christ strengthen and growing. And she only grows by evangelism. Actually, she also has some natural growth, and it's important. At my local congregation, I always encourage young couples and say, God wants us to multiply. But of course, evangelizing is the way, the mysterious and wondrous way that God has chosen to use us to bring into the fold of His church all His elect. And it's a wonderful ministry. So my heart is warmed when I see this emphasis. For that reason, I want to close these greetings with your allowance. I want to close it by reading something from the scriptures, and here's the context. When you talk about multiplication, when you talk about procreation, as I just mentioned, the natural growth of the church, and then the growth of the church, which is also organic growth, by the spreading of the gospel and the bringing of good news to all those that God beforehand has called to walk in Him. We're all talking about multiplication. And I recognize, and I am sure most of you do, no matter how upbeat the mood we have, that we live in times that at some moments we feel like we are foreigners and pilgrims in exile. Maybe not so much an exile in the land that we live, but more in the time that we live. And when the people of God were in exile, and that's in Jeremiah 29, verses 4 and through 7 specifically, have something that God commends to his people living in exile. And it's counterintuitive, and to me, such an encouragement. I hope it will be to you. He begins by saying, "Thus says the Lord God, do not hide, do not shrink, do not circle the wagons," he basically says to his people. "Rather, do business, marry your children, do regular things. Eventually, I will rescue you into the promised land, back into the promised land. But while you are there," and here's what he says that is so precious. Verse 6, "Take wives and have sons and daughters. Take wives for your sons and give your daughters in marriage that they may bear sons and daughters." Here's the key word, and I think there's a very spiritual meaning related to evangelism. "Multiply there, do not decrease." When we feel the pressures of the world, brothers, yes, amen, because you are choosing to double up and to multiply. That is what God has called us to do. Let us do that globally. Amen. Thank you.